This video about whole numbers looks at more strategies for multiplication and division. Another strategy that we can use applies when we're multiplying and dividing with multiples of tens. So this is useful when multiplying or dividing numbers with lots of zeros at the end, because if they've got lots of zeros at the end, then they'll be multiples of 10. You might have heard of these before when we talk about adding zeros or taking zeros or moving the decimal place. These might be phrases that you've heard for this strategy. How you do it is that you separate the calculation that you do so that the zeros, the multiples of 10 bits, you do that separately from the front digit bit. Now we're going to have a look at some examples of doing this. Calculate the following. So in the first case, we're going to do 80 times 500. So the first part that I'm going to do is the 8 times the 5, which is 40. 8 times 5 is 40, so I'll cross them off. I then have one lot of 10 over here and then another 2 over here. So I then need to put 3 zeros afterwards. So the answer to 80 times 500 is 40,000. And if I check that on my calculator, the answer is 40,000, so our answer is correct. In example 2, we're looking at 21,000 divided by 70. So straight away, because we're doing divide, I can take off one zero at the end of each. So I'm then left with 2,100 divided by 7. So I'm just going to do the front bit first and then worry about the zeros later. So 21 divided by 7 will be 3. And I've then got another two zeros to add afterwards, so the answer is 300. When I check that on my calculator, I get 21,000 divided by 70, and the answer is 300. So our answer is correct. One strategy that we can use is to work in stages. Sometimes a calculation can be split up into smaller, easier stages and then put back together again. For example, if you need to multiply something by 4, then that's the same as doubling it and then doubling it again. Multiplying by 5 is the same as multiplying by 10 and then halving. Dividing by 15 is the same as dividing by 5 and then dividing by 3. And there's lots and lots and lots more combinations. What you should try and work out is, when you have a look at these, what numbers are the easiest for you to remember and work with, and then go to those numbers. Use the ones that work best for you. Now we're going to have a look at some examples of working in stages. So now we're going to look at some examples of working in stages. So to calculate the following, for 14 times 8, when I look at 8 here, what I'm going to do is double it, then double it, then double it. So I'll leave the 14, so I'm not doing anything with it. And then for the 8 is the same as doing 2 times 2 times 2. So that is the same as 8. And then, so what I'm going to do then is just double as I go along. So 14 times 2, or 14 doubled, is 28, and then I still need to times 2 and times 2. Then I'm going to go to the next line. I'm just going to double 28 again. So double 28, so 28 times 2 is 56, and then I've still got 1 times 2 left. So then double 56, 56 times 2 will give me 112. If I check that answer on my calculator, 14 times 8, the answer is 112. So our answer is correct. Now we're going to do 600 divided by 15. Instead of doing 600 divided by 15, I'm going to split that up and make it 600 divided by 3 and then divided by 5, because I can split 15 up into divided by 3, divided by 5. That's what I'm allowed to do by when I'm working in stages. So if I then focus on this bit here, if I do 600 divided by 3, that's the same as, so 6 divided by 3 is 2, and then I need
to leap, because it's the 100, so I've now got 200 divided by 5. And then I can just do 20 divided by 5 is 4, and then there's one more zero that I have to attend to. If I check my answer, I've got 600 divided by 15 gives me 40. So the answer is correct.
We can also use an array. An array is a way of multiplying numbers using a grid. It's especially useful for when we're multiplying 2- and 3-digit numbers together. It splits a complicated multiplication up into several easier multiplications, and then it puts them back together again. To do an array, you need to draw a grid that looks like this. We'll have a look at an example in a minute, but what happens is that this is for 2 2-digit numbers, so you would split 2 digits up there and 2 digits up there. Then all of your multiplications happen into these boxes here. Then you do the additions either into these two or these two, and then you add those up and you add those up, and then you should reach the answer in this box. And we're going to have a look at an example of a couple doing some arrays now. Now we're going to have a look at an example of using an array.
Now we're going to use an array to calculate what 23 times 54 is. So in order to do that, we need to split 23 and 54 up into their component parts. So in the case of 23, it's 20 and 3. And in the case of 54, it's 50 and 4. What we then need to do is multiply these in sections and then add them all together at the end. So 50 times 20, 5 times 2 is 10, and then I have two other zeros that I need to add from there and there. 50 times 3 is 150. Then we can do 20 times 4, so 2 times 4 is 8, and then we need to have the 0 at the end. And then if we do 3 times 4, we'll get 12. And now this is where the array puts the back together again. So what we need to do is add up these two numbers and write the answer there, add these two numbers and write the answer there, and then add those two numbers and write the total there, which is the overall answer. Or we can add up those two numbers and write the answer there, and add up those two numbers and write the answer there, and then add up those two numbers and get the total answer there. It doesn't matter which way you do, because if we've done it correct, the answer of adding these two together should be the same as adding these two together. So we're going to do it both ways to check our answer. So 1,000 plus 150 is 1,150. That's a nice easy one. 80 plus 12 is going to be 92. Now I'm going to use my calculator for this next one, but you could work it out manually as well. So I'm going to use my calculator. 1150 plus 92 gives me 1,242. Now, if I'm correct, when I add these up and these up and then add these two, the answer we should get is 1,242. So let's check that. 1,000 plus 80 is 1,080. 150 plus 12 is 162. And then I'm going to use my calculator to add these ones up here. So 1,080 plus 162 gives me 1,242. So our answers are the same, which is good, because so it doesn't matter whether you work that way or whether you work that way, you should end up with the same answer. We can actually check that by going back up here as well. 23 times 54 equals 1,242. So our answer is correct.
In summary, here are some more useful strategies for multiplication and division calculations. Sometimes you can try splitting the multiplication or division calculation up into easier parts, then recombining them. It can be helpful to use an array, especially for 2 and 3 digit numbers. And multiplying and dividing multiples of 10 by separating out the zeros, or the multiples of 10 bit, from the rest of the calculation.